Hi you guys, how's everyone doing? I hope you're all well. I'm here to do a quick video on how to take effective minutes. I think in every field of work, you do have to have meetings, so automatically you're gonna have to take minutes. So what are minutes? Minutes are a record of what occurred during a meeting for the reference of participants. Usually it can serve as a reminder for people that participated in the meeting as to what tasks has been allocated to them during that meeting. Okay, so for my first tip would be, if you know you're going to be taking minutes during a meeting, make sure you have a copy of the agenda. Usually the agenda would have the topics that will be covered during the meeting, and that helps to structure your minutes. It helps you to put everything into headings, and it makes it easier for the reader to understand what you've put down. For me, when I'm doing minutes, this is how I do it. The structure is usually the heading would be the name of the meeting, what kind of meeting it is. If it's a team meeting or whatever kind of meeting it is, the name would be up there. And then the time, the date, the venue, and then the people that were supposed to be there that were not able to attend, I list them all down under apologies. Usually I do a separate list for people that attended, and they can sign off to say they were there, and then they can put their email address. It helps with the distribution of the minutes at the end of the meeting as well. So that's my first tip. My second tip is, actually this is my third tip. My third tip is, you need to be able to ask for clarification if necessary. I know it can be difficult, especially when it's a very formal meeting. It's kind of hard to ask questions like in the middle of a meeting, but then obviously you want the minutes to account for everything that occurred during the meeting. So if you need to clarify anything with anybody that said something, make sure you do, and don't hesitate to do that at all. My second tip would be, your minutes has to be very clear and concise and precise. You need to only make points of what have been discussed, what the action was, and what has been accomplished. So only the important points. During meetings, we can drift off and talk about other things that are not necessarily relevant to the agenda. Those kind of things don't necessarily need to be in the minutes. Only note down the important points, the things that fit the agenda, the headings. So this is where it shows it's quite important to have a copy of the agenda and use that to structure your minutes. I would say read through your minutes and fix all every mistake you made right after the meeting if you have time. If not, the next day, or at least by the end of the week, so everything is still fresh in your head, and then you're able to remember what was said during the meeting. I would say you should also seek approval from your chairperson. Obviously they were the ones that held the meeting and organized everything, so they would have a clear idea of what was discussed. So if they have a look at the minutes, they would be able to make the necessary amendments. Gee, I can't speak today, can I? They can make the necessary amendments before you distribute it to every participant that attended the meeting. Try and avoid using people's names. If a task is allocated to someone during the meeting, I think you can just use their title, team leader is supposed to do this or that, rather than Jasmine is supposed to do this or that. That just keeps it a little more formal. And another important tip is to try not to participate too much in the meeting. It's hard to concentrate on the meeting and be doing minutes at the same time, so just avoid it completely. I mean, of course you're gonna have to say hi to people and all of that, but then when it comes to the actual meeting, let your focus be on the minutes, because this is like an important document. That's the only record of that meeting that you just had. So make sure your full attention is on it and you're able to listen, and then you're able to put everything down. Yeah, I think that's about it. There's nothing much more I have to say. I'm sorry I was a little all over the place. All my videos are like that anyway. But thank you so much for watching, and I hope it's helpful, and I'll see you in my next video. Please rate, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already, and if you find my videos helpful. See ya. Bye, guys.